story Clay in Dubliners, when she was young, Maria worked as a wet nurse for a well-off family with two sons, Joe and Alfie. When Joe and Alfie grow up, they help her get a job at a laundry. Everyone there likes and respects Maria. On Hallow Eve, Maria is set to attend a party hosted by Joe and his wife, Mrs. Donnelly. The laundry women tease Maria, saying that they hope she gets the ring. Maria changes into her best clothes and takes the tram into town. She buys cakes for the children at the party and a special treat for Joe and his wife. She goes to a second bakery where the woman behind the counter sarcastically asks Maria if she wants to buy a wedding cake. Maria buys a large slice of plum cake and returns to the tram. At Joe's house, Maria can't find the plum cake. Mrs. Donnelly concludes Maria probably left it on the tram. Maria almost cries. Joe consoles Maria, who accidentally piques Joe's temper when she mentions Alfie, as the brothers are not on speaking terms. The children play a party game in which a blindfolded person chooses a gift from the table. One of the neighbor girls gets the ring. Maria plays too and puts her hand on a soft, wet substance. Ooh. Mrs. Donnelly scolds the neighbor girl for putting a lump of clay into the game. Maria picks again and gets a prayer book, which Mrs. Donnelly predicts is a sign Maria will go to a convent within the year. Joe asks Maria to sing a song from his childhood. Maria sings, and Joe is moved to tears. Maria represents a feared fate of the time, spinsterhood. Past their mid-20s, unmarried women in the 18th and 19th centuries were considered unmarriageable burdens on their families. Maria was able to nurse two boys, meaning she was pregnant at some point in her life and able to give milk. Maria is almost certainly in the worst of all spinsterhood conditions, a fallen woman, someone who's given birth out of wedlock and who therefore has been abandoned by her family and ostracized by the Catholic Church. In general, Maria appears content with her lot in life. She lives simply, but she's well-liked by everyone who knows her. She does not like to drink, a common escape for characters in the other stories. Maria is quite possibly the happiest character in the collection, a telling fact in itself.